Praying Scripture, Psalm 1, verse 3. Let's read the whole psalm to begin with. Blessed is the one who does not walk in step with the wicked, nor stand in the way that sinners take, nor sit in the company of mockers, but whose delight is in the law of the Lord, and who meditates on his law day and night. That person is like a tree planted by streams of water, which yields its fruit in season, and whose leaf does not wither. Whatever they do prospers. Not so the wicked. They are like chaff that blows away. Therefore, the wicked will not stand in the day of judgment, nor sinners in the assembly of the righteous. For the Lord watches over the way of the righteous, but the way of the wicked leads to destruction. Verse 3 says, the person who does not listen to the ungodly, who does not stand in the way that sinners stand, or sit in the company of the wicked, but who delights in the instruction and teaching of God and thinks about his teaching day and night, will be like a tree planted by streams of water. How much do you desire to be a strong, firm, and fed tree? A tree that is planted by water has enough water to soak up through its roots. This tree is never thirsty. Do you feel thirsty or in need in any area of your life today? Close your heart to the outside world and look within. If you could see your own soul and your own heart, how would it look today? Withered? Battered? Hardly beating? Just holding on to life? Strong with the power of anger and self-determination? Or rested, peaceful, just beating effortlessly? Tell God the state of your inside being today. Talk over with God what you see in your own soul and how your person actually feels. Feel free to pause this recording at any moment that you need extra time to talk with your Father. Jesus promised the lady at the well that soon people would be able to have rivers of living water flowing out from within them. He promised her that if she knew who he was, she would ask him for a drink. He would give it to her, and she would never be thirsty again. Would you like God to water your soul today? Would you like rivers from heaven to be poured over your whole being inside? Believe that can happen now. Believe it and receive it in the name of Jesus Christ. Ask God to fill you afresh with the Holy Spirit, to pour himself into your wounded, tired and weary soul. Say, Father, send the living water into my being. Refresh me. Refresh me, Lord. Refresh me, Lord, that I may be like a tree planted by streams of water. When you plant a tree, it stands firm and does not move. Tell the Lord how much you want to be planted in your relationship with Him. Tell the Lord how much you want to be planted where you can soak up the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is God, the very power of life. Tell God how much you need His life and ask Him to plant you, that your mind will ever be on His instruction, ever seeking after Him. Ask God to give you a desire for Him, a desire to be filled with the Holy Spirit, a desire to live by the stream of His ever-flowing love, presence, and life. This verse says, this tree yields its fruit in season. Giving fruit at just the right time. This fruit must be so, so nutritious because this tree has all the water it needs. It's planted firmly by the river. The Bible talks about fruit. It says the fruit of the Holy Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, self-control. Against these things there are no law. What fruit do you see grows in your life? When a season comes that's not easy, that is when our fruit so often is picked. Sometimes so much of our fruit is picked that we cry out in anger and upset, bitterness, jealousy, or resentment, because we don't really have enough for other people to take our fruit. When the Holy Spirit is allowed to work in our lives, He produces the fruit that just wants to keep giving. Love has enough to keep loving. Joy has enough to keep being happy. Peace has enough to keep making peace. Patience has enough to be patient. Endurance has enough to keep going. Forbearance has enough to keep forbearing. Self-control has enough to stay under control. The fruit of the Spirit continues to grow, because it is not grown by me or by you. It is grown by Him. If you want to have the right and good, pleasant, happy fruit at just the right time in every situation of your life, cry out to Him today and say, oh God, begin to grow the Holy Spirit's fruit in my life. Ask God to change you so that in every situation you will display His fruit in that season. Say, Lord, give me what is needful for every season of my life as I rely on you. The tree does not focus on the fruit, but on soaking up the water, because that's what the tree needs. The fruit just grows. Determine today to focus on soaking up the water, soaking up the Holy Spirit. soaking up your relationship with God, soaking up God's teaching and instruction. Say, Lord, open my ears. I open my ears to you. Lord, take my life. I give my life to you. Lord, bring me into a deeper relationship with you. I want a deeper relationship with you. And Father, you deal with the fruit. The next part of that verse says, whatever they do prospers. Why do they prosper? Because they're soaking up water. They're planted firm in the soil and the fruit is just growing. So they look beautiful. They provide wonderful fruit and the gardener sees them as prosperous. The tree has no sway over whether they stay or go. It's the gardener who chooses whether a tree is prosperous or not. The gardener gets to choose to keep the tree or knock it down. Our gardener is God. He chooses if we're being prosperous. God controls our lives. But clearly, he can use you to be prosperous if you're soaking up him, producing fruit that comes from him. As you soak up the Holy Spirit and give out fruit that the Holy Spirit produces in your life, you become more like God, because the Holy Spirit is God. So what is really happening is that he is being seen in your life. His nature replaces yours, and you become prosperous in life. Because he is God, so he is always prosperous. God's prosperity is not always what we see as prosperity. Prosperity means doing well, having enough. This tree has enough water. This tree has enough fruit. This tree, therefore, looks prosperous to the gardener. It may not be prosperous to another tree if the other tree doesn't see fruit as what is important. Perhaps the other tree doesn't feel the need for so much water and looks at this tree as if it is needy and ridiculous. But the gardener, he sees it as prosperous. Pray now. Ask the Lord to give you his view of prosperity. Not the world's view, but his view. Ask God to make you prosperous before him. Thank God that you can trust him as your gardener in your life. Reaffirm to God that what matters to you is his teaching, his instruction, his law, and how he wants you to live. Cry out now to God. Tell him how much you desire him. Ask him to fill you afresh with more desire for him. Let's pray together. Father, I want to be like a tree planted in you. I give you my heart and my soul. I give you my being, and I ask that you will fill me with a desire for you. Holy Spirit, come and pour yourself into my life. Holy Spirit, let me recognize you and teach me how to soak you up. Holy Spirit, please produce fruit in my life. All the fruit that you want to. Father God, I want to be prosperous in your sight. You are the gardener. Work in my soil. Work in me and make me prosperous for you. I ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. My prayer for you today is that you will be grounded, firm and deep in him, that you will experience him in such a way that nothing will ever take you away from him. My prayer for you today is that you will receive the Holy Spirit, be filled with the Holy Spirit, produce fruit from the Holy Spirit, and prosper in every situation because of your walk with him. God bless you.